Hello, it's Tuesday, the 10th of May. You are watching Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English with me, Ian. Very good to be here talking to you live from London. Do get in touch, let me know where you are watching in the world. It's a little bit grey here in London. It's quite warm, it's about 18 degrees, but it looks like it might rain. Do get in touch, let me know what the weather is like. Where you are in the world. You are watching Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. This is the show where you tell us the words that you want to know how to pronounce, and we show you how to pronounce them. So, welcome to everyone watching on Facebook. Welcome to everybody who is watching on YouTube. Thanks very much for joining us. Before we get started, just a few important things. If you have headphones, then now is the time to put them on or put them in, plug them into your device, and turn up the volume so it's as loud as it will comfortably go for your ears. Not too loud. If you don't have headphones, then not a problem. Just turn up the volume to the maximum so that you can clearly hear all the words that I will be modeling for you today. Now, my accent. I come from the southeast of England, so I have an accent which is fairly typical of this part of the world. But of course, there are many different accents from different parts of England, as well as Scotland, Wales, Northern Ireland, and all the other countries in the world where English is spoken as a first language. So, of course, you will hear some differences, but I think you will find that there are many more things which are the same. Now, this is a pronunciation show, so we're going to be focusing on how to pronounce the words. We might spend a little bit of time looking at the meaning of the words, but we're not going to spend too much time on that. However, if you want to find out more about the meaning of any of the words featured in today's show, then please do take a moment to look them up in a dictionary or online after the show. After the show, not during the show. And if you are interested in expanding your vocabulary knowledge, then let me recommend you take a look at the BBC Learning English website, where you will find many, many fantastic vocabulary related things. You can also find us on Instagram. You can follow us on Twitter. You can, of course, find us on Facebook and YouTube and the BBC Learning English website. Okay, first of all, let's just take a quick look at today's challenge. Okay, so today's challenge has been sent in to us by someone. I can't say your name. I can't read your name there, but if you see your name there, this is for you. So thank you very much for these words. And the question is, which pair of words is not a minimal pair? Now, what I mean by that is which pair has more than one different sound between them? So we've got two words, and some of these words, there is only one difference. So let me say that again. So the question is, which one has more than one different sound? Okay, so we've got three pairs of words, and the question is, which one has more than one difference between them, i.e., which one is a minimal pair? So some of the words have only one difference between them, but some of them have more than one different sound between them. A few people saying Lucy here saying A, Ruka saying A, Manisco says B, Gula says A, Nirala says B. B is different. Bendigam says B. Someone here says C. Ooh, I didn't catch you there. So B, if you've quite a few people are saying B is the one which is not a minimal pair. Sirigul says C for today's challenge. Omar says A. Abby says A. Manish says A. What else we got? Asad says A is the is the different one. Forum says B. And Noman says B, A, and C. Yes, well, it could be possible. Could be more than one difference here. C, someone is saying here, Moore says C. So quite a few different answers for today's challenge. Which one of these is not a minimal pair? We will, of course, be revealing the answer to today's challenge at the end of the show. So do keep watching to find out. Do get in touch as well during the show if there are any words that you would like me to model for you. And I will do my very best to model as many of the words that you put in as I can before the end of the show. If you are just joining us, you are watching Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. This is the show where you tell us the words that you want to know how to pronounce, and we show you how to pronounce them. Let's take a look at some of the words which have been sent in for us today. Spring would like to know how to pronounce porcelain. Porcelain, porcelain. So it's pronounced a little bit more differently than how it looks in the spelling. So it's porcelain, porcelain. And porcelain is the material from ceramic. If you have a ceramic plate or cup, it is porcelain is the another name for the material. So thank you very much for that, Spring. Ming had a question about this diphthong sound O, as in the words groan, bowl, and vocal. So all of these three words contain the sound O. So your question, Ming, was about the position of the sound, where it is where it is created. Really, we could say in the mouth, it's created in the center. Because it has this, begins with the schwa sound, that's really in the center of the sound shapes that we make in the mouth. But the important thing is the transition from the shape, which is just like that, to Now, it's difficult to say, to look at here and say, what's the difference between the beginning and the end of the sound? O, O, O. It's better to kind of look, think about the jaw, what that's doing. O, 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 O. And I'm going to sort of emphasize my lips a little bit to make, so we can see the movement. O, O, O. So we're beginning here, and we're ending there. But it's the transition, O, O, that makes that sound. Okay, so groan, bowl, vocal, all have that same sound, and that's how we make it. O. Groan is a noise we make. Oh, a groan. Bowl, something we might eat rice from. And vocal is the adjective to meaning connected to the voice. So a very good word for this show. Raj, availability, availability. Availability. Availability is the noun from available, meaning that there is something or that you can do something. So, for example, you might say, what is your availability on Friday morning? Are you free? Availability. So the stress syllable is on veil, the second syllable. We're beginning with availability, availability. Thank you very much for that, Raj. Murat has the word reliable, reliable, reliable. So here, the first R-E is pronounced re, with the I sound. And then we have I, the letter I being pronounced I, which is the stressed syllable, reliable. And reliable means dependable, something you can trust or somebody that you can trust. Jamal has the word solidarity, solidarity, solidarity. So the stress syllable here is the first one, sol, solidarity, solidarity. And solidarity means doing things together, doing something to represent all the other people. Solidarity, great word. Okay, let's have a look and see if there's any words. Ah, here's a good word. Julius would like to know the pronunciation of the word conflict. 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 Okay. Abdel, corruption. 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 What else do we have here? Let me just try and grab. Okay. Difficulty pronouncing the word hour. Okay. So the pronouncing here, hour. So this is a diphthong as well, and the sound is ow. So to make the first part of the word is ow, ow, ow. And then we're just bringing it up at the end with a little hour, hour, hour is the pronunciation of this word. How to pronounce occupy? Occupy, occupy. Thank you for that. And religious, religious, religious. So here's another word that begins R-E, but is actually the first syllable is pronounced ri, religious, religious, religious. So thank you very much for that. If you are just joining us, you are watching Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English with me, Ian. Do get in touch with any words that you would like to hear modeled, and I will do my best to model those for you. If you do miss any of today's show, then please don't worry because we will be posting this video on our YouTube and Facebook stream directly after the show, so you can watch it all again and practice all of the words that we are modeling today. And do remember that Pronunciation Live is live every Tuesday at 1:30 and every Thursday at 1:30 UK time. So you can catch another show on Thursday. Okay, let's take a look at some more of the words which have been sent in. So where have we got to in our list? Yes, okay, so here's a nice word from Huda. And the pronunciation is montage, montage, montage. French word, which we use in English. And we have this sound at the end, age, montage, which is very typical of French words in English, montage. And a montage is an artistic device where we put lots of different things together to create something. You often see it in films where they put lots of scenes together of the development of the story so that we can move the story along very quickly, is a montage. Thank you for that. Now, Amit has a little bit here of connected speech. We do like some connected speech on this show. And so what we have is the contraction of would have been. And the pronunciation here would be I would have been, I would have been, I would have been. So we're pronouncing I would have been. Now, probably what's going to happen if we're going to add a word to the end here. For example, I would have been late if I hadn't caught the bus. It would be I would have been late. So this been will get contracted. Well, the sound will get shorter and will become been. So really, if you put this into a sentence, it's going to be I would have been, I would have been, I would have been. So I hope that helps, Amit. And someone's name here that I can't read, but the pronunciation of the word is dawn, dawn, dawn. So it's one vowel sound or dawn. And dawn is the beginning of the day when the sun rises, is the dawn. Miss Sato has some Latin here for us. This is a muscle in the body. The biggest muscle in your backside, I believe. If you do want to find out more about the meaning specifically of this particular word, then do look it up in the dictionary. But the pronunciation is gluteus maximus, gluteus maximus, gluteus maximus. So a nice bit of Latin for us there. And our next word is the word Burlington. So Julio would like to know the pronunciation of the word Burlington. 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 Now, Burlington is a name in English. We find it in lots of different place names. There's a famous shopping arcade in London called the Burlington Arcade. It's also the name of a sock, the name of a bath, and a gentleman's club in Manchester, the Burlington Rooms, I believe. So thank you very much for that, Julio. Let's have a look at the comments, see if there's any words. Oh, here's a really nice word coming in from Roja. And the word is tumultuous. 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 At the beginning of this word, what happens is we get this ch sound. Tumultuous. Tumultuous. Tumultuous meaning very big and fantastic and dramatic. Tumultuous. It's a great word. Another word from Roja is weird. Weird, weird, meaning strange. Asim, this is a good word for a silent letter. So the letter L here is not pronounced, the first letter L, and the pronunciation is vulnerable, 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 vulnerable. So thank you very much for that. Ah, here's a good one from Hoa. So we have the word can. Now, often in speaking, when we do use this word, it's pronounced can. So for example, I can do it, or I can ski, or I can drive a car. If we fully pronounce it, it's going to be can. But usually in speech, we pronounce it can. Now, the negative version of this is the word can't. Now, typically in speaking, we will emphasize it and say, I can't drive a car. I can't help you. I can't do it now, because we want to emphasize the negative. And so my advice with this is to play the difference between the sounds a for can or kn and ah for can't, this long ah sound. And then it makes it clear, because it's important to make it clear the difference between these two words. So in British English, we'd say can and can't. It's the difference between those two words. So we've got, here's a good word. Darlin has the word excursions. 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 So the EX at the beginning is pronounced IH. Excursions. Excursions means days out, small holidays. Here's a good word, which again is a French word, I believe, in origin, and it means the structure of the car, the solid part of the car, and is pronounced chassis. Chassis. So like French words, the CH is pronounced sh with this soft sound, chassis. Chassis. So thank you very much for that. We've got a few more French words, I believe, coming up in a moment. So let's take a look at a few more of the words which have been sent in for us. Tanina has these two words, questionnaire, questionnaire, questionnaire. And a questionnaire is like a quiz or a list of questions that you might be asked to answer is a questionnaire, which is... so like in a survey, for example. And then we have the noun perseverance. 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 And perseverance means to keep going, to not give up, to show perseverance, which of course is something that you must do with your pronunciation. You must keep going. You must show perseverance, and you will improve your pronunciation of English. Thank you for that, Tangina. Let's just have a very quick look at today's challenge again. So just a reminder of today's challenge. The question is, which of these three pairs of words is not a minimal pair, i.e. it has more than one different sound? So a minimal pair means two words which are exactly the same, apart from one difference. But which one has more than one difference? Maybe there's more than one that has more than one difference. Okay, so there could possibly be more than one. But if you think you know the answer, then do put the answer in the challenge. Who, hold on a minute. Huda is saying B. Ava is saying B. Cora is saying A and C. Andrea said B. A, B, Alessandra. B, Farouz. Venus says A. Martha says B. A says Monica. A says Alan. B says Badhouse. Rahul says C. B. Yes, lots of different ideas for today's challenge. We will be revealing the answer to today's challenge in probably about 10 minutes' time. So do stay watching and you will find out the answer to today's challenge. Okay. So let's have a look at a few more of the words which have been sent in for us. Yes. So our next words come from Bijou. And these are all regular verbs in the past tense. So the first word is slithered, slithered, slithered. And slither, to slither, is a verb to move like a snake, to slither. The snake slithered across the ground. So the ED at the end here is pronounced D, because slither, the end of the verb, is voiced. So we have a, so the d is voiced, slithered. The next verb is lurked. So the verb to lurk means to hide, perhaps to jump out on someone, to hide in the shadows is to lurk. He lurked in the shadows. Now, at the end of lurk is unvoiced. So ed here is pronounced t, which is also unvoiced, lurked. And then we have smeared. This time, ed, d, is voiced because smear, ear, the end of the verb, is voiced. So slithered, lurked, and smeared. So for example, if you get something like some jam or some butter and you go, this is smeared across the screen. Slithered, lurked, and smeared. Some great verbs there. Aya had a really interesting question about this, which features in the lyrics to a song from The Hunger Games, I think you said, Aya. And you said that when you were listening to these lyrics, you could hear that in the word midnight, the D is not pronounced. Is that true? Let's listen to the word midnight, midnight, midnight. Yes, you are correct, because what happens is the two sounds, d and n, become assimilated together. So d kind of disappears into the n. So what happens when we're speaking at normal speed is it becomes midnight, midnight, midnight. If we really pronounce it midnight, then you can hear that d sound. But typically, perhaps in a song, you'd hear it be midnight. So we get mi and then night. We're losing that duh sound. So this is a good example of assimilation. So thank you very much. And yes, you are absolutely right. The duh is not sounded. Menisco would like to know how to pronounce the word garrulous. 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 So the stressed syllable is the first, ga. And garrulous means as an adjective to describe someone who's very talkative and likes to talk about silly things, trivial things, things which are not important, is someone who could be described as garrulous. So, yes, here's a good one. This is a verb from win. And the pronunciation here is embroider, embroider, embroider. So the EM is pronounced im, and then broi, da, embroider. So the stress syllable, the middle one, broi. And to embroider means to, is the very sort of delicate art, embroidery is stitching very delicate patterns onto clothes and materials. And the verb is to embroider. So thank you for that, Wynne. Okay, we've got some nautical expressions here from Ezra. So these are all things that you might find on a boat, different types of boat, perhaps. So the pronunciation of each word, the first word is sling, sling, sling. And then we have outrigger, 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 propellers, propellers, propellers. So the P-R-O at the beginning is propellers, stress syllable pell. And the last one is jib, jib, jib. Now, some of these are quite technical terms. I'm not going to try and describe them now, but if you are interested in finding out the meaning of these words, then do look at vocabulary connected to a boat, sailing boat, and also a boat with an engine if it has propellers. So thank you very much for those, Ezra. I hope that helps. Okay, Yvonne has these two adverbs. The first one is inadvertently. Inadvertently, inadvertently. So vert is your stressed syllable. Inadvertently means do something accidentally, not on purpose. And eventually, eventually, eventually. So again, E at the beginning here is pronounced I, if, eventually, eventually, meaning at the end of a long process, eventually we reach the end. So thank you very much for those. Yvonne, Evgeny has two words here, which are good examples of what we call homophones in English. These are two words which have different spelling and different meanings, but they have exactly the same pronunciation. So both of these words are pronounced heart. The first word, heart, is the organ in the body which pumps the blood around. And the second one, heart, is a type of animal, like a deer is a heart. So this second word here is more phonetic, H-A-R-T, heart, is a more obvious spelling. The first word, H-E-A-R-T, is the more common word. However, it has the more irregular spelling, if you will. E-A-R typically is not pronounced R. It's typically pronounced ear in other words, like ear. But in this word, H-E-A-R-T is pronounced heart, just like H-A-R-T, heart. So thank you very much for that, Evgeny. And yes, another French word, I believe, of origin, which we use very commonly in English, is the word connoisseur, 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 connoisseur. And a connoisseur is someone who has a special knowledge about something, perhaps a collector of things is a connoisseur. So a good example of a French word in English. Domenico has the word forth, as in to go back and forth. The same pronunciation, it's a homophone of F-O-U-R-T-H, fourth, as in the fourth. Same pronunciation, fourth, fourth, fourth. Thank you, Domenico. And yes, this is, I believe, another French word in English. I might be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure it is. So Zidane has this word, and the pronunciation is finesse, finesse, finesse. Now, finesse means, it's a noun, and it means to do something with great skill and sort of delicate, intricate detail is finesse. So thank you for that. Mohammed has this word, which is the word iron, iron, iron. Now, iron is a metal. And the important thing about the pronunciation is that the letter R is not pronounced. So we have two vowel sounds, I and U, and we have to get from I to U, but we don't use R, as the spelling might indicate. So the linking sound between those two vowels, between those two syllables, is Y. So it's I, Yun. Iron. 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 Thank you for that. Mohammed. And a really nice word here from Azafi is the word scrumptious. 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 And scrumptious means very, very, very tasty. Scrumptious. It's a great word. So thank you very much for that. Okay, it's time to reveal the answer to today's challenge. So let's just have another look at today's challenge question. Today's challenge question is, which of these pairs of words have more than one different sound? I.e., which of them is not a minimal pair? A minimal pair is a pair of words which has just one different sound, but which one or ones is different? Fan says B, Huda says B, Asad says A, and C are the ones which have a different C. Again here, Angel says B. Lady Lena says C. B, 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 says Salim. Who is going to be right for today's challenge? Biba says B. So there's quite a few people coming in with B here. But are they going to be right? Darlin says A and B. And Daniel says A, B, B, a few more B's. Lily says A, Andrela says B. Okay, let's reveal the answer to today's challenge. So the one which is not a minimal pair is pair B. So well done to all of you who got that right. So let's just have a look at these words quickly so I can show you what I mean. So the first pair of words, we have coffee and copy. Now both coffee and copy are exactly the same apart from the sound in the middle, which in coffee is f and in copy is so that's the only difference. Otherwise, they are exactly the same. Coffee, copy. Now, B is pool and full. So there are two differences here. First of all, the more obvious one, perhaps, is the consonant at the beginning. So in pool is p, and in full is f. So these are the two sounds, in fact, in the reverse order from coffee and copy. We have pool and full. But the other difference is the vowel sound. In pool, it's the long sound oo, pool, oo. And in full, it's the short sound u, full, pool, full. So there are two different sounds. So this one is not a minimal pair. However, pile and file are minimal pairs. Again, the only difference between these is p and f at the beginning. So coffee, copy, pool, full, pile, and file. So well done to everyone who got that right. It was a good game today. Thank you for everyone who took part. And see if you can spot some more minimal pairs in words, words which are very similar. Are they exactly the same apart from one different sound? Or are there more differences? That's a good one to have a look at when you're looking at new vocabulary, for example. Okay, well, you can, of course, join us on Thursday for another episode of Pronunciation Live, where there'll be another challenge, which you can take part in that. In the meantime, do take care of yourselves, everybody. And I look forward to seeing you all next time. Bye-bye.